Hello, I'm Dr. Dennis McKenna. As always, I'm joined by Dr. Venditti, our hospital system general director, providing you the update from Albany Medical Center on the coronavirus. We can report in five counties the number of patients positive for COVID-19 is 1,100. Yesterday, that number was 1,062. So that's about a 4% increase from the day before. As always, we remind you many of those patients have healed and gotten better. We have very good news from inside the medical center. The number of patients we're currently treating with COVID-19 is 61. Yesterday, that number was 66. We actually admitted to the hospital yesterday only one patient who was newly diagnosed with COVID-19. The breakdown on that 61 is we have 26 on the floor and we have 35 in the ICU. And again, some very good news, we only have 23 on ventilators. Fred, since yesterday, we've actually taken 7 patients off of ventilators.
That's right. We've actually been able to extubate 18 patients now. It's really tremendous. We still have 23 patients on ventilators, but we're going in the right direction.
Very good. All right, Fred, why don't we start? You have any questions for me today?
Yeah, I do actually, Dennis. We have a new service for our employees. Why don't you tell us about it?
This is very exciting. So one of the things we've been trying to do from the very beginning, and we're going to talk a lot about this today, is to reduce the amount of foot traffic on this campus. And therefore, the pharmacy has figured out a way to arrange for pickup of medications in our outpatient pharmacy. Starting tomorrow from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m., A building, West Lot, there will be an ability for people to drive up and get their prescriptions from the outpatient pharmacy. In order to do that, you call 262-MEDS, M-E-D-S, and arrange for the pickup time, which is really a great service for our employees, and it keeps people from walking on this campus.
That's right. It's a double win. It's good for the employees, and as you said, it decreases the traffic through the hospital.
On that same theme, yesterday we talked about standby leave, and today we wanted to clarify that a little bit and distinguish that between work from home. Again, both of these are strategies which are intended to take people who currently worked here and move them off the campus in this COVID-19 pandemic. I'll start with work from home. We started this about 4 weeks ago, and we decided that we would very aggressively take people who spend the majority of their time working on a computer and move them from an office space on this campus or another part of our campus and allow them to do that same work, that essential work, from home. And we've had 1,200 people from the beginning that we've moved from spaces here to work they're doing from home. And we can measure that productivity, and we know they're as productive, or in some cases more productive, than they were from home. And that's a durable strategy. We actually think going forward, many of those people who are working from home, same pay, same benefits, might be able to continue to work from home. Now that's different than standby leave.
That's right, Dennis. Standby leave is for employees that work in areas where perhaps there's been a decrease in volume, or in some cases, we've actually closed down some of our clinics or closed some of our nursing units. And the idea there is, again, to reduce the number of people in the building. So those employees are asked to stay home. We keep them whole in terms of their compensation and their benefits. But again, it's people not coming into the institution that don't need to be here. That's standby leave.
And those employees are people who we can call back very quickly if
That's
we
right.
need to.
They have to be available within 24 hours to come back if we need them. And they're told that as we put them on standby leave.
And one of the departments that has been so essential to making this happen is our human resources department. So we thank them for all the great work they're doing to make this happen.
They've done a great job, absolutely.
People may know that yesterday the governor signed an executive order, and I want to highlight what the executive order asks of employers and employees, and then we're going to talk a little bit about that. So this was for essential businesses, which obviously, as we've said in previous videos, the medical center is an essential business. This pertains to employees who are in the workplace. One of the reasons why we've done the things we've done as far as moving people to home is because it reduces the burden on this campus, and this particular executive order only applies to those that are here on this campus. It says that the employer, in this case Albany Medical Center, must provide face coverings, and those should be to employees who have direct contact with members of the public. Fred, why don't you pick it up from there?
So we have been following the recommendations, Dennis, from the authorities. So the CDC and the Department of Health right along. This is another authority that is telling us that we need to provide masks to those members of our community, our employees, that interact with customers, i.e. our patients, or the public. So we're working on a plan to roll that out. We have until tomorrow evening at 8 p.m. To institute that plan, and we'll talk more about it tomorrow.
One of the things that employers would need to be able to do in order to meet that is to have enough masks on hand. And I think we heard some information this morning.
We did. So we've been saying right along that we have adequate supplies of PPE, and that was under the criteria that we were using the masks and other PPE prior to this executive order. We've been trying to get more masks and other items for quite some time. And actually, this morning at 5 a.m., believe it or not, we got a fairly significant shipment of masks delivered here to the medical center. We've actually been waiting for that shipment for almost 2 weeks. So that's going to help us in terms of supply as we go forward with this.
So we should have no problem meeting the executive order for anybody who's here on this campus
facing
the public.
That's right. We will be able to meet the executive order.
Fred, you have on a shirt today?
I do. My shirt today is from the trauma group, and I'm wearing this for a specific reason, somewhat related to them. They do a great job. We're the region's level one trauma center. We take care of the sickest of sick when it comes to trauma. But it's really a prompt for me to talk about care that needs to be delivered. I was telling Dennis before we started that I read an article today from Italy where they were talking about ED volumes dropping as much as 80%. And then subsequently, patients showing up in those hospitals and those emergency departments with much worse conditions. Diabetics wildly out of control, people with acute leukemia that had been sitting on symptoms for weeks and were diagnosed late, etc. So I want to point out to people, we're here, our docs are here, our services are ready to care for you. Don't delay if you're having symptoms, if you're worried about your health. Please come in or go to the local emergency room in your community.
And we've talked in the past about how this is a safe place to come, and this just is another reason to bring that up.
It absolutely is a safe place, Dennis. And you're wearing an interesting t-shirt which applies to safety as well.
It does. It says, I love epidemiology, and these are our infection preventionists and the people who help us to understand everything related to infection prevention, the PPE we wear, the masks. They help us with the science, they help us with the safety component, and we really have a world-class group here. We're so lucky to have them.
They're fantastic.
I'm proud to wear this shirt today. So that'll do it for today. Very good. We'll see you again tomorrow. We thank all of you for everything you're all doing. We continue to get incredible demonstrations from the community that show how much they support what we're doing here, and we appreciate that. I think near the end of the week, we'll have some more on that. Once again, we thank you all, and we ask that you please take care of yourself, take care of each other, and we'll see you tomorrow.